Welcome to Kakatiya online classes. Today discussing about of the second year geology, first unit human anatomy and physiology. The first topic is about dehydration and absorption. In which topic the subtopics are explained here commonly: structure and histology of elementary canal, digestive glands and their functions and their secretions, process of digestion and absorption and assimilation, and then disorders of the digestive system. Before going to know about the structure and histology of the elementary canal, we know about of the basic needs of the all living organisms. Those are food and water. The basic requirement to the all organisms is called as here food. It will be liberate energy and provide growth to the tissues, cells and body of the organisms and repair the tissues. And water, it given the medium to the food, and it will be provides prevent the dehydration process from the body. The food, it will be categorized into three kinds. They called as the carbohydrates, proteins, and then lipids. These three components will be called as the macronutrients. So, which is present in the form of unabsorbable form and complex form. This complex unabsorbable substances, it will be converted into simple absorbable form in the presence of mechanical and chemical processes. Here commonly the carbohydrates, it will be converted into glucose, and proteins, it will be converted into amino acids, and lipids, it will be converted into glycerides, fatty acids. Then these are the macronutrients. Some micronutrients will be here vitamins and minerals. Those components are readily food. It is easy to absorb through the gut walls and reach the bloodstream. Then we have to discussing about of the first topic, structure and histology of the elementary canal. So in which elementary canal of the all living organisms, it will be begins with mouth and elementary canal always begins with mouth and ends with anus. Mouth and ends with anus. Between the mouth to anus, the organelles are mouth, oral cavity, it means buccal cavity, esophagus. Then here stomach, then intestine. Then it will be finally ends with the anus. Here furtherly intestine also divided into small and large intestine part. First we have to discussing about of the mouth. The mouth, it is a transverse slit which is present or visible part of in our body. A transverse slit, it will be bounded with the upper and lower lips. The mouth, it will be leads into the oral or the buccal cavity, which is present upper and lower jaws. The cavity, here it is the oral cavity, which is present into the ventral side. Then nasal chamber is present at the dorsal side, in between the nasal and oral cavity, which is separated by the palate. It is separated by palate. We have been discussing about of the mouth. Then it is buccal or the oral cavity, In buccal cavity region, we have to observe palate. The palate which separates the nasal chamber with the buccal cavity. The palate, it will be anteriorly made up of with the body, hence it will be called as the hard palate. Hard palate. Anterior part of the palate which is made up of with the body, and it will be called as the hard palate. So, at the region of hard palate, it consists a ridges like structure will be called as the palatine gruhi. Palatine gruhi. The posterior end of the palate, it will be soft, will be called as the soft palate. The soft palate hanging at the pharynx region as a elevation or projection like structure. A finger like projection of the soft palate will be called as the uvula. Uvula. The uvula separates the pharynx region into three parts. Furtherly, we have to discuss it. Then, for next one here, the buccal cavity provided with the teeth, and also here about of a muscular organ, they will be called as the tongue. Teeth and tongue. Tongue. Yeah, we have to discuss about of the first teeth. The teeth are means ecto and mesodermal in origin. Ecto mesodermal in origin. The human beings, the adult human beings consisting 32 teeth in number. The teeth, the bulk of the teeth will be composed of the dentine. Bulk of the teeth or overall teeth, it will be made up of the dentine. The dentine, it will be secreted by the odontoblast cells. Odontoblast cells, which is originates from the dermal layer of the mesoderm. Mesoderm. Then your complete teeth, it will be classified into here three parts. They are the exposed part there, the outer exposed part is there, the outer exposed part, it will be called as the earth crown. Their middle part, it is called as the neck, which is embedded with the gums, and here the basal part of the teeth is called as the root, which is fixed at the socket of the jawbone. Here the visible or exposed part of the crown also covered with a layer, it means of a whitish layer, they will be called as the enamel. Enamel, which is called as the hardest substance of the our body, which is also secreted by the amyloblast cells. Amyloblast cells, which is also, these cells also originated from the ectodermal origin. Ectodermal origin. Hence, the teeth will be called as the ectomesodermal origin. The dentine will be, which is originates from the here mesoderm. I hear about of enamel also, which is secreted by the amyloblast cells. Those are originates from the ectoderms. Hence, they will be called as the ectomesodermal origin. So, here commonly, inside of the teeth, it has a cavity. The cavity is called as the pulp cavity. Pulp cavity filled with the pulp. And it is consisting here nose and blood vessels. Nerve fibers and blood vessels, and filled with a pulp. So here the pulp cavity, which is extended through the here basal part of the root, which is called as the pulp canal or root canal. The root canal, it will be joins with the inner part of jawbone. Joins with the jawbone. Any disorder, any pathological diseases will be occurred to the teeth. It will be diagnosed by the dentist, and the root canal therapy will be treated by the dentist. Here about of we have to discussing about of the root part. The root, inside of the root, it will be layered by the membrane, is called as the odontoblast cells. Then it will be followed outside by the dentin, and it is also followed by the cementum substance, and it is also followed by the periodontal membrane or layer. Here outside to the inside and inside to the first, we have to observe outside to the inside periodontal membrane, and here commonly cementum substance, and inward it will be dentin, and also inward it has about of the here odontoblast cells. This is the structure of the tooth. Structurally, it will be divided into crown, neck, and root. Exposed part is called as the crown, which is covered with the layer of the enamel. It is called as the hardest substance of the body. The middle part is called as the neck, and basal part is called as the root. Now we have to discussing about of the dentition. Human dentition and dental formula. Here is dentition. The arrangement of the teeth on jawbones will be called as the dentition. The arrangement of the teeth on jawbones will be called as the dentition. The human dentition will be categorized into three types. They called as the picodont type. Picodont type, and here diphyodont type, and heterodont type. So first of all, we have to discussing about of picodont. Here human teeth are fixed at the socket of the jawbone, hence it will be called as the picodont type. Fixed at the socket of the jawbone. The next one, here diphyodont type one. In human beings, the teeth are, the two sets of the teeth are appears in their lifetime. Hence, it will be called as the diphyodont type one. Dip means two. Here, two sets of the teeth appear in their lifetime. The first set of teeth will be called as the here milk teeth or deciduous teeth. Now, milk teeth are deciduous teeth, which are number 10-20. The milk teeth, it will be replaced by the permanent teeth. So which are in number 32 in adults, milk teeth and permanent teeth. Here two sets of the teeth appear in their lifetime will be called as the diphyodont type. What are the first, milk teeth, and second one is called as the permanent teeth. In heterodont type, here four types of the teeth were observed at the oral cavity of the jawbone. So which are variable in shapes and variable in function. This type of the dentition will be called as the heterodont type. Variable shape and variable in function. Those are here four types. Incisors, canines, canine, premolars, and molars. Here four types of the teeth will be located at the jawbones. Incisors, here they have a sharpened edges. They called as the chisel teeth. So which cutting the food particles. It will be very well developed in the herbivores. Then about of the canine. A dagger-like structures which PN dubbed food particle.